Good afternoon and welcome to Baku. This was the arena, if you think back to 2017, of one of the most eventful races of modern history, with controversy behind the safety car, last second overtakes, and a historic podium for Williams and for Lance Stroll. So let's find out what lies in store for us this year. It's time for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. The Baku City Circuit measures roughly 6 kilometers and is made up of 20 corners and 2 DRS zones. The circuit winds around the narrow city, through the old town, and even brushes against the city's medieval walls. However, as beautiful as the setting is, this track is also a ferocious technical challenge, where the smallest of mistakes could lead to catastrophic consequences for all of our drivers. Joining me for the Grand Prix once again is Anthony Davidson. Let's talk about more. They're starting towards the back of the field today, and the car that is fast. So they'll be disappointed, won't they?
They'll have a sinking feeling as they look up from the cockpit and realise they're in a different postcode to the start line for sure. But the one positive they can hold on to is that the car is quick and they can make their way through the field.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Valtteri Bottas lines up on pole position and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Perez, Daniel Ricciardo, and Albon, Sainz, Norris, Stroll, and Daniel Kvyat, Gasly, Ocon, Sebastian Vettel, and Giovinazzi, Magnussen, Russell, Moore, and Charles Leclerc, Latifi, and Romain Grosjean sits at the back of the grid. It's almost time for those 5 red lights to go out. Then let's see who can prevail today.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to...
Thank you.
Someone's come off ahead of you. There's a yellow flag ahead. Second of the car ahead, get ready to use DRS to overtake. gap behind is 3.1 seconds. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. Engine mode much longer. We're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix too soon. Is out in front. Nice move. Good job. Our gap to the car in front is 2.2 seconds. Work. Well done. We're really happy with the podium here.
And so ends another Azerbaijan Grand Prix. A fascinating race and a well-deserved victory. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team, and they certainly deserve it. performance, making gains at the top of the table. Some amazing talents out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Moore. They fought so hard and had incredible pace at times, so I don't think anyone else did a better job today.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Another team that will be satisfied with this Grand Prix is Alfa Romeo, whose good result moves them further up the championship. I'm equal parts exhausted and elated with this weekend of Formula One. Be sure to join us for the next one.
You gained a lot of positions during the race, didn't you? Another podium. You must be getting used to it up there. Would you say that your rival is still on your level? You're beating all expectations. Would you say we all underestimated you?
Great. Well, that's everything.